Hello, welcome back. My name is Carl. We have been preparing electric powers for the heated steering wheel retrofit to this BMW E90 M3. The heated steering wheel is on terminal 15. Please see episode 1 for more information. And I had shown you how to install a new fuse in episode 2. In my case, however, the only one fuse available on terminal 15 is currently occupied by the dashboard camera. So I need to extend the terminal 15 for the heated steering wheel. In this episode, I'm going to use electrical relays to extend terminal 15. Let me explain this to you. An electrical relay is a switch activated by electrical current. There is usually a solenoid inside the relay to actuate the switch. The relay has 2 pins for the solenoid and 2 pins for the switch. I plan to take the electrical power on terminal 15 as the signal to turn on the relay. And the switch will take power from an empty fuse slot on terminal 30G, thus turning it into terminal 15. And I'm going to use one relay for each of the devices that need to connect to terminal 15. The purpose is to separate the circuit so it will be easier for troubleshooting. So here I prepared 3 relays. Connect the coil pins to terminal 15 and the switch pins to terminal 30G. They will supply power to the dashboard camera, the heated steering wheel, and one for the future project which I don't have an idea of right now. Maybe you have any cool suggestions for me? Feel free to leave a comment below. These are the parts for the terminal 15 extension. The 3 electrical relays and their corresponding sockets. The 2 speed connectors made by Wago. The double leaf spring contacts. One for terminal 15 and 3 for terminal 30G. And the receptacle contacts for grounding points. We had talked about how to find the double flat spring contact in episode 2. Enjoy the internet shopping. Now it's time to access the wire on terminal 15. It is in the back of the fuse box. The walkthrough of fuse box removal is also in episode 2. Be prepared for the tough work. So I think I will hide 3 relays at the back of the fuse box. It may be a little squeezy, but I'm going to protect the relays with anti-vibration tape. So let's go ahead to modify the relays. After 3 hours of meditation, I decided a way to settle down these relays. Okay, so let's first cut them in half. This is how I'm going to do it. The 3 relays stand side by side and joining their negative to one connector and their positive to another. There's an indication on Wago connector. We take 1 centimeter or 10 millimeter. Okay, we open up this much. Slide in relay, close the contact. Okay, good. Then negatively. Okay. Looking like this. Okay, now we just have to take power from terminal 15. Currently it's fuse number 5 on my E90 to here. And ground to this pin. Before we install the relays to the car, let's do a mock-up test. I have a power supply here. I'm going to supply DC 12 volt for activating the relays. Okay, 12 volt. And I already connected the positive lead. Let's connect the negative one. Okay, we can hear the click off, on. Okay, they are working normally. And let's see the current to activate these relays. Total are 0.4 amp or 400 milliamp. I think that's quite significant. So we will consider the wire gauge to activate this relay. So maybe I'll use this thickness for powering this relay. I just take power with this blue wire, goes into here, and the white wire goes to my device or control module. So this is the relay we added to the car. Okay, now what do you think? Do you think the space is enough? Well, I think okay. So I will continue with this setting. I have already found out that the fuse number five here is from terminal 15. And now I have one wire coming out from fuse number five. So I will take this as a signal to the relays to make them switch on. Okay, so I will leave this much. Because of the space is very small, I want to use the help of the other plier. Then that makes my stripping easier. Okay. Sitting very firmly, so now the ignition signal is sent to the speed connector. Okay, now I have a brown wire for grounding the relays. Okay, I hope I didn't cut the wires. Yep. I think I did. Anyway, the current is not very big, so we don't worry about that too much. Open the contact, insert, close the contact. Okay, sitting nice and firm. And we route this grounding wire to the right side of the fuse box. That will go down to the carpet and go into the grounding point at the passenger's side. At the passenger's foot. So it is going to look like this, hiding behind the glove box. We are going to arrange that later. Let's access the grounding point. Removing the trim here. Okay, so if you break any of these clips, and remember to replace them later. Remove the carpet. With the carpet removed, you can see the grounding points here. We have two grounding points here, and you can see this pin is empty, so I'm going to use this slot. Again. Looks okay. I removed the grounding point for easier work. And now let's insert our contact. Good, set in place. Bear with me now, because I have to work with only one hand. The camera is in my way. So now the grounding points for the relays are done. After proper arrangement of the wires, let's put the carpet back in. Okay, we can continue our work with other devices. I have a dashboard camera on my car, so now I have to prepare power. I'm going to take power from fuse 22. So let's first add the wiring to fuse number 22. Black socket here is corresponding to fuse 22. Just insert the contact. This wire to the relay. Squeeze. Okay. Now we have a crimped contact. Okay, and now this wire to the dash cam. Nice. To here, let's go to here. Okay, whoa, the contacts are all in place. And the relay goes back in. Okay, now the connection is good. Let's repeat the preceding step for the remaining two relays. So now we have extended two new fuses slots for terminal 15. In my case, I have made fuse slots 24 and 25 available. In the next video, we will take fuse slot 24 for the heated steering wheel. Please don't go away. Let's do some protection to this wiring harness with this Tesa 5/16/18 Fleece wire harness tape. This is used to reduce noise and also makes your work look good. Put it back, put the plug back to the fuse box and make sure your fuses all go back to their places. Let's protect our relays with this fleece tape. Okay, how does that look? The fuse slot for the heated steering wheel is ready now. The main course is coming in next episode. In addition to swapping the steering wheels and running the wires, we are going to talk about the heater control module and wiring diagram in detail. Please subscribe, find cars and good people, turn on the notification, and join us again in episode 4. Goodbye!